Good evening and welcome to the Dana Center on the campus of Bentley University in Waltham, Massachusetts for the Division II East Regional Semifinals. Our second game of the night pits the host team at top seed, the Bentley Falcons, against the number four seed, the Knights of Queens College.
Inside for Lux. Nice catch on Elise, head gully on her hip, and the Falcons with a quick six. Again, quickly up the floor. A high-low inside, it goes to Gemma. She goes to the left and scores again. Make it 11-2, Bentley.
Yeah, Queen's a bit out of sorts.
Colia for Green, tries her hand to the three, and there's the first one for Bentley. Feeds White, quick swing of the ball. Green for three again, two in a row for Lauren Green. She's in double figures, and Bentley has their largest lead at 30-19. Officials letting them play here. White in the corner, launches the three. Yes, sir. Three threes in a row for the Falcons. Timeout called by Queens.
Eight have been called on Queens, six on Bentley.
Green for three in a corner. She's made three in this second quarter. If we get any word, we'll pass it along, but we know for sure she's not in the game right now. Madison hits the pull-up jumper at the foul line.
Her kind of as the anchor defensively in that zone.
And a turnover caused by Madison Rowland. Korzybinski, nice touch pass to Madison. Back-to-back hoops from Madison Rowland. Queens now on an 8-over run.
They'll ice up in the second quarter and be back out there in the third.
Another Falcon turnover. White's pass wayward. Here comes Madison Rowland in transition. Scores another one. She's got all 6 points in the second half. Here's White for three. Off the back rim. Madison Rowland the rebound. Queens a chance for a lead here in this transition opportunity. Merrick Rowland lays it in. And the Knights have themselves the lead for the first time.
Right now, Beth Lubovsky and this Queens team, they're on defense, they're clicking on all cylinders.
Full court pressure broken by Bentley, and Mackie Smith goes all the way to the cup. The first field goal for Bentley. First game here where there were so many lead changes. That's what it's been the last couple of minutes here in the third quarter. Mackie Smith again to the basket using the Colia screen. Green defended by Merrick Rowland. Disrupts the dribble. Now inside for Mackie Smith, who got away from Mayhem.
Well,
and Green trying to turn the corner, lost the handle, recovered, pushed it to Mackie Smith. In the corner to Bennett, who launches a three and buries it. Trevina Bennett, the sophomore. Green behind a Lewis screen, drills her fourth three of the game. Back-to-back threes for the Falcons.
See that as you know, if you're a Bentley fan or Barbara Stevens on another end, you makes you a little, you worry a bit because you still want your
Trevina Bennett, her second corner three in this fourth quarter. They'll call off the Dogs, and the Falcons are on their way to the regional championship game. A 77-67 victory for the Falcons. That was anything but routine as Queens came at them with both barrels in the third quarter.
All right, thanks, Steve. Standing by here with Mackie Smith, and I'm going to go back to the third quarter. Midway through the third quarter, your team was really struggling with that pressure defense. You come into the game and able to help break that pressure, a couple of easy buckets. You got lost in that zone defense. What were you able to do to help stop that Queens run in that third quarter?
Well, Coach said to just handle the ball, be poised with it, look for skips, passes, dribbling. So I tried to drive the ball, look for my open teammates, and thankfully they were open and they knocked down some really crucial shots.
Now you're Jen Gemma today, maybe not her normal game, let's say. A lot of foul troubles, so a lot of time on the bench. But how about the play of your teammate Melina Colia coming into the game, a career day for her?
Yeah, she did phenomenal. She stepped up when her number was called. And I think Jen was also really helpful in helping Coach Melina through the bench and like when they were playing together.
Now, in a game like this where a lot of adversity, how comforting it is to be on your home court, to have earned this during the year, and when you fall down against this Queens team, to look, you're on your home court, settle things down. How important was that?
I think it was huge because we've been practicing since pretty much September. So being able to be on our home court, feeling confident, shooters are shooting well, drivers are dishing, passing. So I think it was really helpful that we were able to be on home.
All right, Mackie, congratulations on the win.
Thank
we'll
you.
See you on Monday night.
Yes, thank you.
All right, here with the coach, Barbara Stevens, and I just said to you before we came on the air, another tough one for your Bentley team. You got to fight a lot in that Northeast 10 tournament. Yesterday, maybe not as much adversity, but today, a lot of adversity, trouble with handling the basketball. But I was just talking to Mackie Smith. She, in that middle of that third quarter, she came in and was really able to steady the ship against that pressure defense.
Yes, she was. Mackie, you know, is a good steady ball handler for us, but she's also a very aggressive offensive player. And she's one that can attack the basket. And honestly, that's what we needed. We needed somebody with some aggressiveness to come in, and I think that turned the momentum right around.
Jen Gemma had to deal with some foul trouble today, not her prototypical game. Still scored 16 points in the end, though.
Right.
But Melina Colia off the bench, also a junior, maybe someone who doesn't get as much time as she would hope on the floor, but you know, it's probably something that she was waiting for in her career.
Right. Melina's one of those kids that comes to practice, works really hard, and you know, she just waits for her number to be called. Some games, there are better matchups for her games. Other games, you know, with people who spread the floor, it's not such a great matchup. But fortunately, we could use her today. And again, she came up big, just like she did last night.
How important is it to have this day off tomorrow, get yourself some rest after going up and down the court with this Queens team that likes to run, and prepare for this NYIT team? I guess early thoughts on them and having that day to check out some tape.
Right. Well, number one, we all need the day, for sure. But we'll take the day to prepare. We have played, or we did play NYIT back in late November, early December. We've seen them once, but they're a much, much different team. They're playing with great confidence. They have great shooters. You know, they have the ability to score inside. So, again, another unbelievably difficult game for us, but that's what NCAA basketball is all about.
Yeah, you're used to it this season with all the tough games you've had. Great win today. We'll see you on Monday night.
All right, thank you very much.
That's the coach, Barbara Stevens, her Bentley team, on to another regional final, and they'll host it Monday night against NYIT.
From my broadcast partner, Scott Sudikoff, and the entire crew here at the Dana Center, thanks for being here at the Division II East Regional in Waltham.